Today we're going to talk about headaches and migraines. Do you suffer with any of these? And have you been wondering what is causing them? Well, today we're going to talk about six reasons for headaches and migraines, and I'll also discuss natural headache remedies along the way. If you haven't met me before, I'm Dr. Janelle Sinclair, and I'm a biochemist and natural medicine practitioner. And on this YouTube channel, we usually discuss natural strategies for depression and anxiety. So subscribe if that interests you. Make sure you stick around to hear all of the six headache and migraine reasons, as I'll be starting off with the most basic ones that you may have heard of before. But the last two or three are not well known or recognized, so stay around for those. So let's discuss headaches and migraine reason number one, dehydration. Make sure that you're drinking enough water. I know that this is simple and basic, but we've got to cover off the foundational keys to health first before we move on to anything more complicated. I think that we often know what we ought to be doing, and so I'm sure that you know that you should be drinking more water. But the question that I have for you today is, are you? Are you drinking 1.5 to 2 liters of water every day? Make sure that you start today. Headache and migraine reason number two, magnesium deficiency. Magnesium is a key mineral and is involved in over 200 biochemical processes in the body. And a magnesium deficiency is very common in people that suffer with migraines and headaches. Magnesium deficiency can cause really tight muscles because magnesium's involved in the relaxation of muscles. And so therefore, you can have tension headaches because of this magnesium deficiency. It's also thought that magnesium is involved in down-regulating excitatory neurotransmitters. That's the chemicals in the brain that stimulate the brain. And so if magnesium's low, it can lead to kind of a heightened excitatory state of the brain, and this can mean that you're prone to migraines. To help reduce or prevent headaches and migraines, consider having an Epsom salt bath every second day or taking a magnesium supplement every day. Standard dosages for magnesium are 200 to 250 milligrams a day. Keep in mind that it can take 2 to 4 weeks for these natural headache remedies to work and for you to get some relief, so be patient. I put some links in the description below this video to some good quality magnesium supplements, and by purchasing through those links, you'll support this YouTube channel. Headache and migraine reason number three, reactive hypoglycemia. Reactive hypoglycemia is low blood sugars in response to what you're eating. When your blood sugars drop in your body, you can have many symptoms, including fatigue, brain fog, yawning, forgetting your words, anxiety attacks, sweating, irritability, and mood swings. However, another symptom of low blood sugar is headaches. I've created a really comprehensive video on blood sugars and its relation to mental health concerns. Although that video isn't focused on headaches, it's very practical and informative. It goes over the symptoms of reactive hypoglycemia and diets and natural supplements that can help too. So check out that video, especially if you're someone that knows that you get hangry or that you have to eat very often or you have anxiety or depression alongside your headaches. I'll include a link for that below. Headache and migraine reason number four, progesterone deficiency. So this headache and migraine cause is only applicable to females and those menstruating or going through menopause. Progesterone is a female sex hormone that is produced in the ovaries of ovulating women and in the placenta during pregnancy. Its major role is to prepare and maintain the uterus for pregnancy. Progesterone is also a key player in the regulation of the menstrual cycle. Common symptoms of a progesterone deficiency include breast tenderness, fluid retention, acne, headaches, irregular heavy or painful periods, infertility, endometriosis, and anxiety. These symptoms are usually experienced 1 to 2 weeks before the period is due. So if your headaches or migraines are cyclical, that is, they come regularly at a particular time of the month, then you should look into progesterone deficiency. If you haven't asked yourself whether your headaches or your migraines are related to your menstrual cycle, I suggest that you start recording when you get a headache and whether it is 1 to 2 weeks before your period or not. I have a video on progesterone deficiency symptoms, and it will direct you to some natural remedies for progesterone deficiency and therefore how to reduce headaches and migraines before your period. Moving on to the fifth reason for headaches and migraines, salicylate intolerance. Salicylate intolerance is actually something that tends to run in my family, so I have a personal experience with this. And I would see my father, if he ate the wrong thing, he would actually get really bad muscle tension, and this would lead to headaches and migraines. And in the past, I was like this to some degree. So what are salicylates? Have you ever heard of them before? They're natural chemicals found in our food. In fact, they're found in lots of fruit and vegetables and spices that are rich in colour. They're really good, and they're not bad for us. They're definitely good for us. But some of us are sensitive to these natural chemicals. I suggest that you Google a salicylate food list and that you trial limiting foods that are high or moderate in salicylates for a couple weeks and see if it helps. I don't love the low salicylate diet because it limits many healthy foods, but as my family knows, this natural headache remedy definitely works for some people. So headache and migraine reason number 6, MTHFR gene mutations. So this last reason for headaches and migraines is one that is genetically based. So if headaches and migraines run in your family, perhaps along with depression, anxiety, or other mental health conditions, infertility or heart disease, then take a look at this one. MTHFR stands for methylene tetrahydrofolate reductase. I know it's a bit technical, but when you have a genetic weakness or gene mutation in the MTHFR gene, you can have a higher risk of migraines. The scientific studies are quite strong on this. The MTHFR gene encodes for an enzyme that helps convert folic acid into the active form of folate, known as methylfolate or MTHF. If you have this genetic weakness, you can compensate for it with special types of vitamin B12 and folate, and this can prevent and reduce migraines. I've created 2 comprehensive videos on the MTHFR gene mutation, its symptoms and treatment, so you can find out about this really interesting migraine cause by watching them. And thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you next time.